ultimate journey, traveling the country and experiencing creativity and art demonstrations. And now, we're live in a city near you, whoever you might be. It's the Kraaft It Live Art Concert, an art show with fun, laughter, and a few mistakes thrown in too. Follow along on Instagram and see behind-the-scenes images by D-Dog, fielding your YouTube questions, Sylvia and Mr. Crafter. And now, your host, Heather Crafter.
Hello, everybody. Welcome to Kraaft It Live. I'm your host, Heather, and I'm very glad that you're here. I have got wonderful, wonderful news this month. We are going to be working with PanPastels all month long. I'm really excited about that because I did do a practice over the weekend and had a good time with the PanPastels and being able to create some, I don't know, I thought it was a pretty cute thing that I did. So I'm kind of excited about that. A really big piece, and I thought we'd duplicate that for our first piece this month. Not that image. We're going to do something different. Let me get it. See if you can see it here. You should be able to see this. So do you guys remember when we went to Bryce Canyon on our trip down here from Arizona? We took some pretty awesome pictures, and I think with the help of Jules, I picked out one that we can do today. We're going to work on this. So we'll see how this goes. Maybe we'll get through it all. If not, we'll continue it next week. But if it works out and we're able to get through the whole piece today, then the rest of this month is going to be using PanPastels in different ways, like mixed media and stuff like that. So we'll see how it goes. Stay with us on Kraaft It Live here on Tuesdays all month in February, where I heart PanPastels. So let's take a look at today's message, T, and let's see what we've got for everybody today.
Hi, everybody. Today's message is, He guides me in paths of righteousness for His name's sake. Psalm 23, verse 3.
Oh, my goodness. That was Sylvia. You guys hear that? That was Sylvia. She's sitting here in the background the whole time I'm talking and making faces at me. And, you know, she's just being all kinds of fun. But anyway, so we are ready to get going here on...
Oh, shoot, hang on.
That's all right. You got it. All right. That looks pretty good, doesn't it? Shoot. Is the color okay? All right. So she's sitting here making faces at me, and I'm trying to do it straight-faced.
Wait a minute. You guys can't hear me?
Oh, probably because T-Dog had himself muted, maybe.
Oh, no, I didn't have myself muted. We're good.
All right.
No, she's not mic'd.
No, she doesn't have a mic on because we couldn't get that darn lavalier to work for us, but we'll keep working on it if she shows up every Tuesday, which was a real big win for us this week. So let us do one step at a time. All right, so here's what I'm going to do. You guys saw that image at the beginning during the opening where I'm going to be doing this. I'm just going to take a sort of a neutral color out of this, and I'm going to put in some guidelines just to get going. So there, you get to see Sylvia. That was all that you're going to see of Sylvia. All right. I've just got some pastel paper on the board, by the way. And
it's really pretty pastel paper. Can you talk about the differences in pastel paper? Because you have some light pastel and dark pastel and stuff like that.
Yeah, of course. Now she's here and she's going to make me do stuff. That's great. So... So I had to go get the paper because I forgot that part. This is what it is, so you can see that. Okay, so Sylvia, I don't know if I have to repeat what you say, if they can hear you asking.
They can't hear me.
Okay.
I'm trying to move the mic to where they can hear us both, but I don't know.
All right, so basically she's asking about the pastel paper and wants to talk a little bit about that. Oh, I went too high. You know what? We get to learn how to erase right off the bat. So the first thing I'm going to do is take a tissue paper. I got so nervous because Sylvia's here. So I'm just going to take a piece of tissue and just sort of wipe off the excess dust. And then I've just got a regular eraser. It's just a vinyl eraser. And I'm going to go in here and just erase.
He'll try next week when you get time next week.
Try getting you a mic.
Oh, get me mic
down. Yeah.
Yeah, that's okay.
Are the two of you talking on there?
Yep.
Yep. Well, now there's two of them here, and they're still not going to talk to me. They're only going to talk to the audience. That's awesome.
Hey, that's what we brought
that's
her
That's what
in here
we
for.
Brought her for, yeah. That's true. All right, so there. We're starting over.
Okay. See how easy it is to erase when you do pastels?
I love it. Okay, so I...
Okay, wait a minute. Tell them what you're using. What pastel are you using?
My God. This is burnt sienna is what I've got. It's just a neutral color out of the image. And we're just going to start a little bit lower. That's what my problem was. And I'm just giving myself a line. And I'm not, you know, I have a really good picture of this. So I'm not trying to make a picture. I'm just trying to recreate it with my pan pastel. So keep that in mind as we're going. All right, I know that I've got some deep crevices here. And I want to make sure I get these shapes in. So that's what this is.
Okay, we have a question from Jules. She wants to know if that's a nice paper to use for pastel because she heard it is, but she's not sure.
It is so far. I've painted on it once. So.
You did your other one on this paper?
Yeah. Yeah, it was a different color, but yeah.
Okay, you've done other pastels. Have they all been canceled? Because I thought we didn't. I thought that gray paper was something different.
No, I've used Strathmore and I've used Canson now.
Which one do you like better?
They're the same.
Okay.
All right, so the key points that I really wanted to hit were these lines in here. There's some crevices in here.
Okay, Kim is asking, she says she has trouble keeping the tips on the tools. Any suggestions, or do you have that problem?
No, I don't have that problem, but I will tell you that if you don't put it on, like, baby socks, like, inch it down. This was a pain when I started. So you start putting it on. Hopefully you guys can see this.
Yes,
I think you can.
I can see that.
So you start putting it on, and what you want to do is each side, you just sort of like baby socks. You just sort of pull it down, pull it down, pull it down, pull it down until it's on there. And then if you can tell that it's not on the tool, it's not all the way on. So you got to baby socks the other side until you get it on. You have to be really careful because you can rip these really easy.
Yeah.
So you just cinch it down, and then once it's on there, it will stay on. You don't have any problem staying it on, as long as when you clean, you go side to side. You don't go up and down. You
well,
just go side.
Off, but not down.
And you really don't want to do that. You just want to go side to side when you're cleaning.
BJ says that she only uses her fingers. She doesn't have any tools.
And that's fine too, because they're fine for that. There's no need to.
Jules is saying,
you use a lot more pastels when you use your finger, though.
Yes.
Yes. So.
Did you hear that, BJ? You're using more.
Yeah, you use more, but you know, if that's what you got, that's what you got, right?
And Jewel says that she heard sandpaper or sanded paper is better.
I have also heard that,
so
and
what
I think.
Does that mean? You actually take a piece of paper and sand it down?
No. No, it's paper that has a sandy texture to it.
Oh, okay.
And they might work better. I was watching a guy who does prefer those over any other paper. But the art, what is it called? What is that one? The board. Not aqua board, the other board. Pastel board?
Pastel board.
Ampersand.
Yes.
The ampersand boards, is that what it's called?
Yes.
All right, I think it's ampersand. Anyway, they have a great pastel board, but it's rougher than this paper is, and I didn't like it as much. It seemed to eat up more of my sponges, and maybe I'm rougher. Maybe that's because of how I use it.
One time when you and I did a pastel, I think I used that dark blue paper.
Yeah, and it was kind of rough.
Oh, my God, that was so rough.
Yeah, it was awful.
Yeah.
All right. Okay, so I drew in my lines where I really want this to go, and I really just want to make sure that I remember this is dark areas in here. I have some dark stuff back in here, but I'm just giving myself an idea. All this will probably get moved over a little bit. as we go. I just have an idea. So this is the rough sketch. Wow, rough sketch, and it's, what, been 30 minutes? Okay.
Well, 11.
It feels like we're never going to get this done. Okay, so here's the key that I'm finding with PanPastels. The bigger, when you start, the bigger, the better. So I've got this really big sponge, and all my sponges look really dirty, but I sat down with my paper towel, and I cleaned them. So there's some on there a little bit. I just do that, and now it's good. Okay? And you can also wash them, and then they'll look like this anyway, but they won't. None of the chalk will come off, pastel will come off.
The color on it, but
I mean, like, I've got these other ones here. These are clean. I washed that in the sink with soap and water and let it dry, but it still looks like it's got stuff on it. Anyway, okay, so let's go into the...
Corey K.
All right, hello.
Hi, Corey K. I don't know if you can hear me or not, but Corey K is so excited to learn pan pastel. I was just purchasing some yesterday. Thank you for starting at the very beginning how to keep the tips on.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, and ask your questions as we go, and I will do my best. And if we don't get through this painting today, it's no big deal. We will get back to it next week.
Oh, no. Kim says she bought a bunch of them and got frustrated and threw them away.
Oh, my gosh. My heart just broke a little bit. Okay, Kim. New rule. If Kim doesn't like something, she calls Heather first. Okay? New rule.
Or you can glue them on, you know.
I mean, really? Wow. Okay. All right. So all I'm doing is mixing between these colors. So here's what I love. You're going to hear this all month long. Here's what I love about pan pastels.
And what is it that Heather loves about pan pastels?
Well, to begin with, because there's going to be a lot. Yeah. To begin with, I love that you can just mix them like they're, you know, just an open palette like this. So I can just dab in here, I can dab in there, I can go dab over there, and I've got three colors on here, and I can just...
Can you bring that up closer to the camera so we can see the three colors that you get on the actual sponge? Do the sponge. Yeah. Dip the sponge on the first color, and then dip it on another one, and put it up closer to the camera so we can actually see the colors. There you go.
All right, all directions by Sylvia today. All right, so...
Heather's going to tell me to leave.
No, never. So what I love...
Again?
What?
Can you do that again?
People, help me.
No, seriously, I'm serious.
You're going to have to just pay attention and catch it when I do it, okay? All right, so I'm just going through. This is what I love about this.
Talk, you know, from Corey K, she wants to know, do you start pastels light to dark?
No, it doesn't matter. This is what I'm saying. So another reason why I love pan pastels is because there's really no rules. Now, I will tell you that there are people who are going to argue with me, and that's fine. They can. But I've fixed every problem that I've come across. So I don't see any reason. Where's my white?
You can hear me or not, but we have Alice. Our pan pastels creamy. They're dry. They're not creamy, if that's what you're asking. They're dry to the touch, like a blush would be, a cake blush.
Yeah, so here
They really are creamy. I mean, they feel nice and soft and luxurious.
Yeah, I'm going to switch my. I need to make sure that it's not. Yeah, it looks really ugly. Do you see that? It looks really ugly on there. Yeah. But it's clean. So I'm going to go into the white. See that? Okay, I'm into the white, and I'm going to just go in here and add some white for my sky.
Are you leaving me?
No, I'm trying to take pictures. It's okay. It's okay.
And so you see how splotchy it is. It's quite everywhere, right? Well, this is okay because as I'm taking this big, wide sponge, and T-Dog's taking some close-ups for you, so you'll be able to see them on Instagram. But as I take this big wide sponge and add swipes in here, so see, it's not light to dark, it's not dark to light, there's nothing about it. It's what do I want to put on? So you really don't even have to think about it too much, and you can fix it if you didn't like it. So if this is the color you don't like, and use larger swipes. I don't know if that's making any sense or not, but I'm sort of using a turquoise and a turquoise dark shade turquoise. I'm really liking that. That's starting to come together. So see how it's blending so nicely on there? Do you see that? Now over here, it's still pretty choppy, so we're going to work on that some more. And I'm looking at my reference photo. It's almost a flat blue. Well, that's boring. We're not doing that. So we're making the sky. Oh yeah, there was no clouds, nothing. Yeah, it was boring. So. So there we go. That I like that. That's starting to blend quite nicely. So let's go ahead and that white on this side here, and I'm just going to add to that some of this turquoise light and this ultramarine blue light. And we're just going to come in here and just sort of wisp it in. Now I can already tell that my brush is too big. So I'm making, the marks that I'm making are too big. So I feel like I need to get into a smaller brush. In this case, it's a pan, a sponge, but you get what I'm saying, right? So I need to move over to something more like this sponge.
Okay, we have, Corey K wants to know if they create the dust that pastels normally do.
They do create some dust. I won't tell you that they don't, because they do. If you could see this up here, it's so much lower. Yeah. And I think that's why I love them.
Why?
Another reason.
Okay. I don't know if anybody can hear me, but I've got the headset on. Yay!
Oh my gosh, T is in heaven, you guys. T is in heaven. He no longer has the microphone, and he gets to get up and take
so
pictures.
We don't, no, I was going to say we don't hear anything. I don't need to hear anything because I'm in the room with you.
She cracks me up. She says, how am I going to be able to hear the other people? I don't have a headset. I said, what other people? I'm just saying, we don't know. It's all
right. Okay, it has to do with 120 miles I've already driven this
morning.
Well,
that's very true. Yeah. It has nothing to do with that. Nothing at all. All right, so what I'm doing here is I'm just going in straight into white. And I'm just filling in where I know those clouds are going to be. So a lot of this is just like when you're painting with acrylic paints or even watercolor, it kind of looks crazy when you begin because it's like, that doesn't really match what I wanted it to do, or you know, I'm sorry, let me go slower.
No, I'm trying to get you in.
Oh, we're having too much fun here, guys.
Heather, why don't you explain about the different
I can't do slow motion and explain at the same time. Have you figured that out yet?
The different color tones in the pan pastel, because each color has like a set of four that goes with it.
Yeah, that's true. So this is not a good set for that. Let's see here. All right, so here's how you're supposed to do this, okay? I don't have all of the colors, so... For example, this right here
should be a tint.
I think I have these in the wrong place.
The blue should be in order, right? No. Okay, don't let it fall.
Hold that one. Hold that one. Yeah. Oh, okay. Push it down then. All right, bear with me here. This is a learning class. That's what this is, you guys. So, bear with us. Okay, here we go. So this is violet. This is violet tint. This is violet shade. I'm sorry. This is violet extra dark. So what would go here would be violet shade, which would be just a darker version of this. And then you have the extra dark. So you'd have the actual color is in this column. You have the tint, you have the shade, and then you have the extra dark. And that's the way the colors work. So it's all violet in that row. Okay. I don't have them all. So I just do it like this because it's easier for me to hold it that way. But, like this is magenta right here, light tint, which is the lighter version of that magenta. And then this one is extra dark, I believe. So it should be there and we should have a shade here. And then you can mix all of these straight up and down. You can mix them, you know, in and around each other. But what happens with what I love about this is that when I mix, when I go this extra dark, which you can see hopefully, this extra dark, and then I go and I put this magenta over the top of it, there's just like this, you can see that, I hope. Can you see that?
Yeah, we can see
so
that.
I have this line of magenta on top of that extra dark, and when I go to put it on, it creates this like two-tone. It's beautiful. Beautiful. I've already got my shading right there on the brush. That's like a dual load acrylic paintbrush almost, you know?
Yeah, remember when we did those flowers?
Oh,
yeah. Oh, my gosh, those were so pretty.
All right, now I have to switch my brush up, though, because... And I'm going to say brush, even though they're sponges. You're just going to have to get used to that. Although I don't know where. Okay.
Oh, Michael says, Sylvia, so good to hear you. Yay!
Yay!
Good to be heard.
It is good.
She's had me gagged for too long.
Oh, yeah, that's what it was. All right, so I'm...
Andrew wants to know, he says, may I ask what time the next train wreck is scheduled?
Yeah, yeah, good luck.
Next week, Andrew.
All right, so I'm just going to add some gray into the bottom of some of these, and you're just going to see it just sort of wisp in. And we're just going to... Wow. This kid, I tell you.
And T-Dog is posting away.
I'm trying to get fired.
I guess. All right, so all I'm trying to do here is just add some drama to the bottom of these. Oh, my goodness.
So check. Oh, my goodness. T-Dog's got a lot. Oh, my. He's got some really close-up pictures.
Awesome.
Yeah,
so check.
This is awesome.
Be sure to check out Instagram and Photo by T-Dog. He's doing his thing, you guys, and it's making him very
happy.
The
pictures that T-Dog's got on Instagram, you can actually see the texture of the paper, which is really pretty cool.
Just remember, you're using the same Wi-Fi that the show is using, so buffering may occur.
I'll close down. You know what? I'll turn off Wi-Fi. No, I'm using my own T-Mobile.
Awesome.
Okay, I'm not even connected. It
awesome.
Doesn't see you.
No, it's great because now I can bug you again.
Yeah, he's really happy about being able to be in my face
and
over
here. Jacqueline's
here.
Hi, Jacqueline.
Hi, is that JC? Is that JC? She made it to a
no,
live
Jacqueline
one?
Veach.
Yeah, that's JC.
Is that JC?
Yeah.
I don't know her name by Jacqueline Veach.
I know.
Hello, JC. Oh, no, Lisa has to leave us.
Oh, I'm going to cry a little. Will we make it without her? Do you know there's a replay? She knows there's a replay. All right, I'm liking how this is headed, but I need to get away from it because I'm moving too much, and I need to fill in some of here so I can see just how that all plays out. So let's go back to the big swipey swipey.
I like that. I like the colors underneath the clouds.
Yeah. Thank you.
Very pretty.
All right, we are going to go into some
oh,
of that.
We have...
Go ahead.
Karina? Katarina?
Okay.
She's joining us. She says, hello, I'm new to the live stream. Well,
we're glad you're here.
You.
Welcome. You're going to have a lot of people talking in your ear because we are all very excited. We're excited to be in the same room, right, Sylvia? Aren't we?
Thank you, JC.
All right. What I don't like about the color choice that I made for this paper is the other paper, I'm going to go grab it for a second. What I did over the weekend was a darker paper. So my lighter
Did
colors showed
that,
up
Heather?
Better. No. So this is, I'm just going to show you guys. This is a darker paper. Can
yeah.
you see that?
Yeah.
I don't know if they can see it online or not, but it's a darker paper. The border around the picture is actually this color of the paper. And this is a very light paper in comparison, making it very difficult to put in my light swipes. Because you
really,
can't see
because
it.
Because you can't see it so good?
No.
What paper brings out the better colors? Because I thought that made a difference too.
Well, okay, so here's what I was listening to. Somebody who knows what he's doing, I guess. And he was saying that you should always use white. And I honestly do not agree.
Okay, Heather's using right now currently Canson. Me, Tinnies. Something like that. 112 eggshell. It's MITEINTES.
So what I did was I went to Blix Art Materials, and I went to their, what do you call that stuff?
The drawers?
No. In the back by the drawers is a, like, open stock.
Yeah.
And they had paper that is good for pastels. And when I looked it up online, everything said, yes, that is a good paper for pastels. So that's what I chose. Am I totally blocking the image as I'm standing there? Guys, nobody's telling me. It's T-Dog's fault. He's over on Instagram, so.
Wow, that's really pretty.
I haven't bothered you or blamed you, I mean, for anything yet, so. It's only fair.
One time.
There you go. All right, so I'm just laying this in. I want these horizontal stripes. That's what I'm trying to get, and I couldn't get them with the lighter color. Let's go left-handed, see what happens. That sounds like fun.
She's ambidextrous.
Well, she's not really, but we're going to try. So I'm putting in these darker values because I really want to be able to put in the lights, and we're hoping that we can put the lights over the top. Oh, okay. Thanks for watching our back there, Junk. You guys know that that is one of T-Dog's friends.
Who?
And
Wait, hold on.
I'm sorry. It is his one and only friend. He has no other friends. Everyone say, aww.
Who's that?
So show her which one that is, please.
Right there?
Yep.
Oh.
I told him about the show, and then he started watching.
Yeah, because he was here. Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, he's been here a couple weeks, and we're very grateful
cool.
that
That's
he's joined.
So cool.
It gives,
glad you're here.
Gives T-Dog somebody to complain about the show, too, that understands now. All right.
Linz isn't here. She's not feeling good.
Do you want me to get to stop? Is that what you're telling me?
No.
Okay. All right, so these are what these are called hoodoos I'm trying to put in here.
Hoodoo?
Hoodoo. Hoodoo the voodoo that you do. The hoodoo. That's what they're called, hoodoos. I didn't make it up. So I'm just blocking this stuff in. So like I said before, it's going to be an ugly mess for a while, and we're okay with that. As we're just putting in these basically block of colors here, just so we can get an idea of where we're going with it. I really don't like that I chose the lighter color paper, though. I wish I would have gone with the darker paper. I think I could have done a better.
You'll make it work.
Oh, I know I will. And these are, again, the hoodoos right here.
Okay, BJ said something Faber-Castell, right? I don't know what that's in reference to, BJ. What's that in reference to? Let me know, okay, so I can get that answer for you.
All right.
JC's going, I love Blix, yeah.
Yeah, I love Blix a little too much. I was actually there over the weekend.
Yeah.
I was there, we went, what, Friday, was it, T-Dog?
I think so, yeah.
Yeah, yes. We went Friday, and then, I got home and realized that even though I had a sheet that told me all the colors I had, I still bought three of the wrong colors. So we went back on Sunday, and then, of course, I found one of them was broken. So we had to figure out how we were going to fix it, because I was not driving back to Tempe after that. Wow, this is looking like a hot mess, isn't it? This is the scary part, because people are watching. Like, the whole time I was doing this, nobody was watching. I mean, I did have the camera on, but I sort of forgot.
Yeah, that is different.
It's very different. Well, that's true. They could see in the camera. And that video we should have up sometime next week, I think, if I can get it done. Maybe this week. I don't know. Miracles do happen all the time. So.
Oh, you are too. You're taking lots of cool pictures. JC says that she's got you up on her TV.
Oh, now that's exciting. So
cool. I did that a couple weeks ago or something like that. I had Heather up on TV.
That's so exciting. So I can actually tell people I'm a TV star because I'm on somebody's TV somewhere. Oh, that's pretty cool.
And BJ says we're worth putting up with the buffering, so I guess there must be some buffering issues going on.
Well, that's what happens when there's posting to Instagram like crazy.
Oh.
Yeah.
Jules just said her YouTube notification just popped up.
Oh, that's funny.
Oh, my gosh. We're half an hour into the show.
Yeah, thanks, YouTube. We appreciate you being there.
Kathy Whitney is joining us. Hi, Kathy.
Hi, Kathy. Thanks for being here. We are, believe it or not, we are actually painting a painting. I should keep trying to show the reference photo. This is where it's going. Trust me.
Eventually.
Trust me. Travis, you're leaving it on the chat, or is that... Oh, I see. Okay. Stay out of his business. Sorry. Sorry about that. I know better. What was I thinking?
Yeah, Michael Ann. Yes, that is paper she's working on. Once again, it's Canson. And it's a number 112 eggshell. It was originally a larger piece of paper, but she trimmed it down to size.
Oh, I just trimmed off the edges because it was too big for my board.
Yeah.
And then there's some pressing. What do you call that when they do the words? Like they press the word into the paper?
Oh, yeah, yeah.
And
what's that?
I don't know. Watermarking, I guess.
No, watermarking is... You know, but that's almost like embossed.
Yeah, it is. Yes, Travis. Okay. Mm-hmm. All right. Thank you for that.
Yeah, everybody's saying embossed, embossed. Yes.
Yeah, it's embossed.
Or it's
so,
like letterpress, too, because letterpress raises the letters up, too.
So. Yeah, so think about it. You're taking this pastel and you're rubbing that over the top. It very much accentuates those letters.
Yeah.
So yeah. All right, so I'm just going to go in here. Again, I'm using a very large brush or sponge. Remember, I'm going to call it brushes. So I'm not really working the details yet. I'm just trying to block some of this in. But now as I'm seeing what I'm doing here, I want to do more. Like I don't like in my reference photo, I have a very large section right here that is almost white. It's a very light tan. I'm going to show you here. Very light tan ledge of rock here. Mm-hmm. And I don't know that I necessarily want to make that prominent in my end photo. Same over here, there's another one. So I think what I want to do is just make, I'm gonna take some license and make what I want. What do you think of that? So here we go. So I'm gonna be adding some more colors. We just swiped on several trying to think of what this called, like several.
He muted me, not to worry.
No, you're right. Okay. Trying to think of what I'm trying to say while I'm doing this, but it's not a good idea. You can also I'm just trying to block in these hoodoos up front and make sure that that's what I want to see there. And then I think we're going to have this one. This is going to be just more of a gaping hole here, like a cavernous area.
Well, JC, I live about, I think it's 54 miles one way from Heather. So it's about an hour drive, but that's just, we're still in the valley. The Phoenix Valley here is huge. It's just huge. And so I try to visit as often as I can, but I kind of took the month of January off because I had other things I had to take care of.
Yeah, and we're really glad that you're back, Sylvia, because this...
But she's back!
She's back!
Not going to try and be here every Tuesday for the show, at least. So.
Wouldn't that be so awesome?
But also, I take my granddaughter to and from school every day, and so it's important that I don't get caught in traffic, so, you know...
She's here, and then she leaves us.
Yeah.
So she's here for a little bit, but then she leaves us, so...
Because traffic after about noon in Phoenix 50-mile trip could take an hour and a half to 2 hours. That's why I got to get out early.
All right. Now, I don't know if you guys can see this or not. I'm trying really hard to use my left hand so I'm not blocking everything with my body. But now I'm starting to put in those spires, or they call them hoodoos. I'm not making that up. Hoodoos.
They're not spirals?
No.
Oh, because those are, they're drips.
They look like spires.
Yeah, spires,
you know, they,
right.
Like they're coming out of the ground and everything. But what it is the wind erodes it away. Wind and water erodes it away, and it makes these. And I guess there's nowhere else in the world that they look like this. I don't know.
Really?
I don't know. I didn't really read all this stuff. I just was in awe of what
spelled?
I was seeing. H-O-O-D-O-O. If you look up Bryce Canyon. They have these weird shapes to them. So this was kind of an ambitious project to take on all of these, to be honest with you, but we're going to make it happen. And like I said at the beginning, if we have to continue this next week, that's what we'll do, because it's all about PanPastels this month.
Because we are totally known for doing the same project.
Well, I know T-Dog gets irritated with this sometimes because he thinks that it's boring, I think, but...
Well, I think it's cool. I like it when you kind of devote a month to a project.
But if we're gonna do it right and not rush through things, I feel like we kind of have to sometimes. So.
And according to Wikipedia, it says, while hoodoos are scattered throughout these areas, nowhere in the world are they as abundant as in the northern section of Bryce Canyon.
Abundant.
Abundant.
All right, that's what
all
I meant.
All it has to do with being abundant.
Yep. All right, so now I'm using the, I don't know if you guys can see this or not, where I'm doing this part. But I am using the tip of the sponge, a little bit of brown on there, and then I'm just going to go in and carve, basically, some of that detail on those. And just because I want you to see some of that before we go today, this is probably not going to stick around because we're not ready for detail there, but I just wanted to see how you would put in some of that. These have these sharp edges, these sponges do, which is another reason why you would want to use them. And you can just go in and put in. Tea, this might be a good time to take a close-up of this so that they can see these details on Instagram of what I'm saying. When you use the sharp, I can just...
Jules is saying how much she loved all the pictures you took on your journey. Yeah, they were amazing.
Yeah, and I did share some of that on with a few people.
That's great.
Too.
Wow.
So hopefully you got to see. If you follow on Facebook, for sure, I put a photo album up there, and I tried to add to it, but I don't know that I was successful because I really don't know how to use Facebook very well. So I tried, but... Anyway, you kind of get the idea here. Maybe I don't know if they can see that, but
posting some pictures over on Instagram. You got some really great close-ups.
That's awesome, and that's what we needed to hear. Okay, so I'm just going to switch up my palette. So this is another reason why I love PanPastels, is because I can flip from here to over there, and I don't have to wait for drying.
Right.
So I've got some of that red iron oxide on there already, and I'm going to now go into this violet. This is the violet dark shade there.
Oh, that pretty.
Yeah, and I'm sorry, that's magenta, not violet, and I'm going to go ahead and put some on here. That's the bright magenta there. And we're just going to go in here with that sponge. Now, don't get in my way on this one. You're going to get all bossy with me, and I'm trying to do something serious here. All right, so I'm just going to lay this down and pull it across. No.
Wow.
I'm trying to do this. And I don't know if they'll be able to see that online. It's really a thin layer of three different colors just going across there.
You mean like this?
Yeah. T's got a picture he's going to post. Maybe you can see it there. All right, so I'm going to do that again. And I'm going to switch it up a little bit. We're going to go this corner and this corner. I'm going to do that again.
Uh-oh, Andrew's leaving us. Bye, Andrew.
Bye, Andrew.
It was nice chatting with you.
You should be able to see some lines now. Because you can say little snide comments and you don't think anybody can hear you.
Not everybody needs to hear what I'm saying.
Not everybody needs to be exposed to the T-Dog.
We love listening to you, T-Dog. But I want everybody to know that he's an amazing technician. When I got here, he was busy setting things up and testing stuff. And I was like, wow.
Yeah. She's like, don't get in his way. All right. So can you see those lines that I'm putting in there? Can you see that, Sylvia, from where you're sitting?
Yes, we can see them.
Okay.
Yeah. Not as good as I can see them in person, but
well,
that's one of the perks for coming in person.
Well, and that's, you know, what's really funny that you said that is I was going to say that's what's going to set apart why people might want to come to our Kraaft It Live art concerts when we get those up and going. You might really want to consider being a part of that because then you'll get to see this stuff in person.
Your friend's still here too.
Yeah.
So Junk is still out there. That's awesome. Thank you guys for being here and those of you who are still hanging out with us, even though this really doesn't make any sense at the moment. I'm going to switch to a small one now. We're going to get detailed a little.
That really looks pretty, Heather.
Thank
you. Doing there?
So now what I've got, I'm just going with the magenta light. So this is just magenta light on the sponge, and I'm using a little rectangle, and I'm going to use those shapes to my advantage. So I'm going over those stripes that I put in, but because pan pastel is like sheer, it's almost like makeup. I mean, that's what they tell me. I don't wear makeup, so I don't know, but I can just go right over the top and you can still see those shapes, those stripes and everything in there. So, and now I've got the impression of, I don't know if you can see that or not, but I've got the impression now of those hoodoos in the back.
Yes, you do. And through Michael Ann's help, JC got her name changed back to JC instead of the confusing one that
that caught you off guard.
Beat Gino. So, yay, JC's back.
Yay.
Oh, Michael Ann says she's never seen the sponges, only the wand tools.
Oh. Well, can I just mention that Michael Ann being here is kind of a surprise and a joyous surprise, I must say, because I read that Facebook post and I thought we weren't going to see her here. So I'm grateful that she's put us on her list of social media hangout. Michael Ann?
Oh, yes.
Yeah. All right.
Oh, Jules helped too. Okay. I got to do the shout outs. Michael Ann, Jules, and JC is back.
Woohoo! All right, so now I'm going to grab some green because this is where I need to add in some of these. So we're just going to focus on this area, I think, until we're done here today because if I don't, we'll never end ever. So I've just got the corner, same sponge. I'm still in the same sponge and I'm using the corner of it. Just go in there and sprinkle in some of these little bits and pieces that I see here on my reference photo that's saying that there are some leaves or whatever these things are. I don't know what he's up to. Are you doing this live to the folks? Messing with them? Their view? They'll love you for that. No? These are some trees up here. Does that look like trees?
Yes, it does.
That's looking pretty good up there, huh? Yeah. I'm getting quiet because I'm concentrating on the details. That's the way it goes sometimes.
And I'm getting quiet because you're getting quiet.
Just make me nervous. No big deal. Okay. What are you thinking?
I'm just mesmerized.
Okay. Oh, it feels really good to have you here, Sylvia. It's so nice to be able to, and not that there's anything wrong with T-Dog being here and chatting with me. It was a lot of work for him running the show, plus the Instagram, and then putting up with me. I think the hardest part was probably putting up with me. The rest of it's probably pretty easy. Not that he will admit it, but.
What?
Yeah.
What are you,
Nothing. I'm not.
Nothing. Jules says they look like trees to her, so.
Oh, that's all that matters. That's all that matters to me. I got Jules' approval. I'm good to go. Jules has the reference photo on hand, too, I think, so she's probably able to say, no, that's not right, Heather. What do you mean?
Well, they're saying there's some audio.
There's a video problem or something.
Uh-oh.
So I'm going to stop.
Okay, so everything seems to be working okay for people now.
All right.
This is why we need some kind of like music in the background.
Well,
sing.
Yeah. If it wasn't a copyrighted issue, we probably would have some already, but.
I mean, all of the songs that I would sing are copyrighted, so I don't want to.
Be creative. Write your own.
No.
So in these areas where. This is, again, I'm going to say it again, why I love PanPastels.
I like the detail that you're putting in back there, Heather.
Thank you.
Looking
so
really good.
What I love about PanPastels is how you can layer these colors, and then I'm going to go in, I don't know if we could, we probably can't zoom in this area here. It's probably in as close as it'll go. You know what I could do? Manual zoom.
Heather's doing a manual zoom, people.
All right, what did I do? Did I just mess it up? Did I mess it up?
Okay.
Okay, so in this area here, okay, I want to create this look here.
Okay.
Do you see it?
Mm-hmm.
If they can see it right there. Okay, so natural instinct would be to go in with a light color, because that's what it is, going with light, and we'll go over the top. And because these are sheer, you almost can't see that. All it does is sort of mix in with that, so it really can't see that very well. Okay, no problem. We'll just go the other way. We'll go dark, and we'll go around the back of it.
Want to say hi to Arthur Moorhead. He's here.
Hi, Arthur.
And he's glad to see you're up and running again. And he says it looks like a landscape. It's so cool about PanPastels that you can go light to dark, dark to light, and stuff like that. I just think it's so cool. And you don't have to wait for dry time.
Yeah, that's my favorite part. Well, and the cool thing, okay, so like when you're working with regular sticks, you go so far and you've loaded the paper up with all the pigment it'll take. Like, it just won't take any more. But with PanPastels, the pigment's actually on the sponge, and you're just adding it to, like, pushing it into. And that's why I was saying you can't just go in with the lighter color right there, because it's just going to blend like we did right there. See?
Mm-hmm.
But then if I don't like it, if I don't like it at all, I can take and, like, just push it off, wipe it off, and I can go on top of that. Isn't that crazy?
Yeah, that's so cool. Jules says when she first saw the pictures of the hoodoo, she was wondering how to paint and draw it. She said, this is so amazing how Heather has it figured out.
Well, I don't know that I have it figured out, but I definitely am enjoying the challenge. I love that I can put this. Now, I'm not capturing the light very well at the moment, but I don't really care. I'm having a good time. There's some of that light right there. Putting that in. Well, that's good that you're not saying that, because I'm not moving out of your way, T. You're just going to have to work around me.
And Arthur says you didn't mess anything up. Your blocking in steps look great. And how do you, question is, how do you seal pan pastels, Heather?
Well, you can use any pastel fixative, like that one that we have that I can never remember the name of it. It's
begins with an S.
Yeah, and it's basically, what is it, cow's milk or whatever the heck it is. I can't remember. I can't remember what it is. People are going to be laughing at me. I can't remember what it is called.
I've heard hairspray, too.
Yeah, hairspray can, but it can also cause yellowing. So, I mean, if you really love your piece, probably not a good idea to use hairspray. But if you're just playing around with cards and stuff, if you're doing this with cards, are you just going to mail it to somebody? Hairspray is perfect.
Yeah, I've sealed pastels before, and they seal pretty good.
Yeah, and I've even, another thing to love about pan pastels is the lack of need to seal the way that you need to seal stick pastels.
Mm-hmm.
They just don't rub off as easily. Look at how we're doing that, adding some of those shadows in there. Do you see that?
Left.
Thank you.
And then JC wants to know, so how is smearing prevented then?
Well, it just doesn't really happen very much. Now, on this paper, it happens a lot more than it does on the ampersand boards.
Okay.
On the boards.
It seems like it's stuck on the board. And you
oh, my gosh.
Anything,
yeah. Right? Look at this. This is a piece we did. I don't remember when we did this. Okay. All right. It's on there. Is that upside down? No, that's the right way. It's on there.
Yeah.
It doesn't come off. So.
And that really chewed up your sponges too, didn't it?
No, that wasn't too bad, but it was not great.
Yeah.
To me. But. Yeah, I don't know.
SpectraFix.
SpectraFix. That's what it's
that's
called.
It. Thank
Who
you.
Said that?
Jules did.
Jules gets the golden prize. I don't know what the prize is, Jules. I'm just telling you, you get it. Okay. Woohoo. So.
And then she also, JC said casein?
Yep, that's the word I was trying to say. Yay. So one thing that I do notice that I really liked about this picture was all the pinks and purples that are back in here. So we're not going to go away today because we're almost done for the day. We're not going to go away without those pinks and purples being in our.
BJ says she uses hairspray for her ATCs that she does.
Yeah. And there's.
But she says it darkens the lights.
Yeah. And it will.
And Arthur said leaning the canvas forward keeps the powder and crumbs off the surface. So Heather's almost perpendicular with that one. It's pretty straight up.
Yeah, and there's no real powder when you're dealing
yeah.
with pan pastels. So it's a little different than sticks.
I didn't like the sticks at all. I got rid of my sticks.
Yeah, she gave them to me. And I like them. I have no problem using them, but I like these more. I really do like these more. Okay, so you get the idea, I think.
Jules says that SpectraFix has darkened it too, but I haven't seen that, so I don't know. Maybe when I spray, I put very, very light, extremely light.
Yeah, it's you got to do it in layers.
Yeah.
You got to be really patient with it, I think.
And I don't know how many layers I've put on, but I just like whew, real quick.
All right, so we have blocked in. I don't know where the camera is here. We have blocked in the sky and pretty much the idea of where we've got our lights and our darks. And we started to do some detail work over here that I'm probably not going to stick around with, but Over here, we've gone in a little bit better with our detail, and as we get closer and closer, we'll have some pretty defined shapes. We'll deal with all that next week.
Show this again.
Well, no, because then people will see what it's supposed to look like. All right, here we go. Let's see.
See the darks that she's talking about? That she
Yeah, you can see those darks in there, and you can see there's those pretty colors. I don't know if you can see those over there or not, but I will post on the website. I've gone back to blogging, y'all. I will post this image that I took when we were at Bryce Canyon. I'll post that as our reference. And in the future, we're going to have reference photos and sketches and all those things available to members of our website when that gets all up and running. So I appreciate you joining me today for this block in and introduction to Pan Pastels here on the Craft Shaak, and I hope that you've enjoyed it so far. If you have any questions, you're watching this in the replay, or you just want to find out more, leave us a comment down below. We're here to help you. And honestly, we learn every time you ask us a question, so we'd appreciate hearing from you.
Well, we have a couple questions here, you know, before you go, okay?
Mm.
Michael Ann did a nice suggestion. She said that the Spectrafix that she had didn't come in with a real nice fine mist bottle. So she actually poured it into one, which you can do because there's all sorts of different bottles out there that have different sprays on them. And so that would work real good. And then Arthur said, your video and sound quality is great. What kind of headset?
Oh, my headset is a Sennheiser. Sennheiser 800 or something like that. I think. Arthur, I think if you go back to one of the H&M shows where we, Michael and I did our setup of, he did his setup and I did my setup. My setup has all of the equipment and a link and everything about where you can find everything that I use. So.
Okay, good.
All right. And that's available in the user-to-user community, which I know you are already a member of, yeah. Arthur. So,
yeah, all of you are members of the user-to-user community, right?
I don't know. I don't know. All right, so I think that's good. I think that's good for today, and we will catch you back next week where we will hopefully finish this piece. We'll see. I'm not going to try to do too much off camera. I might do some things just to get me to where I know where I need to be, but we'll talk about it. And then
well, everybody's been enjoying watching you put the technique and the detail and laying down the foundation. And stuff,
good.
So
good.
I don't think they want to see a completed picture.
No, there's plenty of picture here to finish. So. We'll get to it next week, and I appreciate Sylvia for being here. Thank you so much.
I'm back.
You guys make sure you tell her that you're glad she's back so she returns, okay? All right, and thank you, T-Dog, for the pictures. Appreciate it. And if you are new here, let us know because we want to know what you think about everything. Give us a thumbs up, share it with the world, whatever you can do to help us spread the word. We're going to be taking this on the road to a city near you soon. So thanks and have a crafty day, everybody.
Bye-bye. Bye, everyone.